Don't get it twisted. If you're coming here, it's a zoo, bro. Everyone that comes here, they're like, bro, they were raised by gorillas and apes.
What's up, guys, and welcome to the video. So just to briefly introduce myself, my name is Eric, and I'm a junior here at UMass Amherst studying business, and today is Thursday, which means that it's my busiest day in college because I have 3 classes today. But on top of that, I also have an exam for my hardest class, and it's not gonna be fun. So on Thursdays, I usually wake up around 9:30 to get to my first class at 10, which is going to be Introduction to Management. And this class is necessary for everyone that's a business major, so it's in this huge hall that I wanna say has about 400 to 500 students in it. Damn! And that's another thing I wanna show you guys today is just how big UMass is and how wild things get over here because they literally call it the zoo. Today is definitely gonna be a super productive day in my life here at UMass. So if you guys are interested, definitely make sure to keep watching. So with no further ado, let's go.
Best ways to cash one. We've been good for less. Bro, lacking ever. Wave it every dexter. Ways from the neighborhood. Blunt's biggest banister. For the summer, never lose. Boy, I said we messed up. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Bitch want say so. I want Alfredo. My dog want Cardeo. Serving Laredo. Hopping out the farm. It look like a mango.
Alright, so as you guys could probably saw, that class is huge, and we had just taken the exam a couple days ago, and all the scores are out, and all I'm gonna have to say is this is gonna be an uphill battle for the rest of the semester. But one thing my professor was talking about was this kind of weird scaling thing where he said that if you did really bad on this exam, then the next two, if you do considerably better, then he'll basically drop this one and make it worth less, which doesn't really make that much sense to me. But it's still beneficial because basically he wants to see that you're putting more effort in for the rest of the semester. But right now it's 11, and usually after this class I head to the dining hall, which is like an 8-minute walk away, but you know, with the skateboard it's like 3 or 4 minutes, and I'm gonna go get some food.
I'm still fucking up all the time. Yeah, I know I'm not the only one. Yeah, I still can't get shit right.
So the way dining works here at UMass is one swipe gets you unlimited amounts of food from the 4 dining halls, and since I had gotten there past 11, the food switched from breakfast to lunch, which means I was stuck eating sushi and fried scallops, some noodles and some kung pao chicken, and some pho for breakfast, which is pretty crazy, I know, but honestly, I'm not complaining. Even though I've been here for almost 3 years now, the food here still just doesn't feel to amaze me. Alright, so right now, as you guys can tell, I'm at the library. Usually on days like this, my next class is at 1 o'clock, which is the class I was talking about, the hardest one this semester. Instead of class today, we have the exam, which is kind of weird because it's not in class. So basically, we have any period to take it between 8 a.m. to midnight tonight, and it's going to be for 2 hours, even though the class is usually an hour 15. But right now, basically, I have to do just a really quick 30-minute information crunch session and just try to learn everything. So this class that I keep referring to is called OIM 350, which stands for Operations and Information Management, which is actually also my major, and I won't bore you guys with the details too much, but this major entails a lot of data analytics and manipulating large amounts of data to use them more efficiently. And right now we're working on a lot of SQL and Tableau, and somehow my study session turned into a nap session real quick, and I ended up waking up right when I was supposed to take the test. Alright, so we just finished the test. I'm starving right now. Someone left their berries here, so you know, I might just... These are juicy. Imagine someone comes back up like, hey, those are my fucking berries, you bitch. Eat a berry, bro.
Dude, these are like 11 out of 10 berries.
I've been working for me, not sorry, nice.
Okay, so honestly, I pulled up to the class. I stayed for maybe 10 minutes and I just left because the class doesn't really provide that much substance to me. I'll try to play a clip. I don't know if the audio is valid, but literally the things we talk about in here, every single class is, what is a brand? McDonald's, Starbucks, Amazon.
Nike, Ford,
Honda,
Walmart, Coke, McDonald's.
I don't know. I don't want to sound negative or sound hateful towards a teacher because she's a great person, but I think I'd rather just do work and then learn everything from the book because the book just provides more substance and is way more direct than sitting here for an hour and 15 minutes. So basically, this situation is just playing my cards according to what's really going to benefit me the most, and leaving the class, although it sounds bad at face value, is just going to benefit me the most. Okay, so I finally am done with everything school-wise that I need to for the day. Marketing was my last class and I just met with my group to work on a presentation that we're gonna do on like Tuesday or Thursday next week. It felt pretty good to get that out of the way. And now I'm super tired and I really need to refuel my brain, so I'm gonna head to a dining hall which is right next to Eisenberg. It's called Frank, and this is probably one of the oldest dining halls on campus. And then after that, I'm gonna meet up with one of my friends who lives on this part of campus, which is called Central. And honestly, I never come to this part of campus because I just live so far, but with the skateboard, it's really accessible. King, geez. Same old story, you can get soaked or soaked in glory. I got a house in the sticks, it's awkward. I know that my neighbors are voting Tory, surely. Fredo's my brother, we're locked in for life. I told bro to drop me some game, my American things, they're too impolite, right? So right now I'm with my boy Nick, and someone did a hit and run in his car recently.
You the person who did this, I'ma fuck you up, just know. Your mom is a hoe, your dad is a bitch, grandma's a chief. Everything. Look at this, bro, scuffed up my headlight, scuffed up my front quarter panel. This school is called the zoo for a reason, bro. Don't get it twisted, if you're coming here, it's a zoo, bro. Everyone that comes here, they were raised by gorillas and apes.
People here are straight reckless. They hit his car, did not leave any type of note or anything. And now my man's just fighting for his life, calling insurance left and right. But right now we are at Central or slash O'Hill, which is called O'Hill because it's on a huge hill. You can't even see the bottom of it. Like, this hill is really steep. Like, it's actually crazy. But this part of campus is actually honestly one of the chillest parts of campus. It's like, I guess the type of people that live here are like earthy, crunchy people, but it's not limited to that. It's just honestly a bunch of chill people. Southwest is the area that people party at, so they're cool, I guess. But if we were to categorize Central and Old Hill, it would be chill. I honestly cannot imagine living here. But now Nick lives here. In my first vlog, he used to live in Sylvan, and he told his little scheme of how he's gonna finesse and end up here.
Pretty much told the housing people that I have anxiety and high stress, and pretty much they said that they understand and that they're gonna give me high priority in the next housing selection process.
Now he has a single in Central, which is definitely a huge come up, but I'll show you guys what Central looks like right now compared to the Honors College. It's definitely much older is what I can say. Bro, this place is the zoo. The zoo. It smells. It smells like sweat and just overall bad stuff. But one thing about Central is that there's no elevators at all. So if you want to get up, you have to walk. And that's exactly what we did when Nick moved in and he had to move his fridge. Damn, bro, this room looks like depression. Why you got the shades down, bro? It's the sunniest day.
Nah, bro, when you walk up the hill, like, they can see me.
So oh, really?
Yeah.
Let me see.
It's a clear view. Like.
Oh, dude. Baby, give me mental when she on her menstrual. Like a baby got info. Pull up in a Benzo. Hey, smoking out the rental. First jump, this dude, no warm up, nothing. Oh, yo, this dude is the only dude I know that's taller than me, and he retired playing basketball. I'm gonna have to get him back in the court though for intramurals. All right, one more dunk. Oh, one leg, yeah. Yo, is that Michael Jordan, bro? Yo, I think that's Michael Jordan. Oh my God. Oh my God.
All right, so if you guys couldn't tell from the background, I'm here back at the same exact place on the same exact floor that I was 9 hours ago when I was taking that test with my friend. And man, it's really been a super long day. I can't even lie to you guys. Also, I want to say that all my days aren't usually like this. Although yesterday was pretty similar to this, but today was honestly funner because I got to bring you guys along with me. And I got to hang out with one of my friends because honestly, some days I don't even see my friends like that. I know it sounds kind of crazy because we all literally go to the same college, but as you guys probably also saw today, this campus is huge, so it's kind of hard to link up sometimes.
All right, so basically where I live is behind that building right there. I live behind it. So that's how you can tell this campus is pretty big.
But I haven't been back to my dorm for like 13 hours and I kind of just want to take a shower, but I have one assignment to do before I go home, so I'm going to get that done. Whew, and call it a day. Super busy day, super productive, but I feel like the more things I did, the more energy I had to keep doing more things, if that makes sense. But overall, very satisfying. Thank you guys so much for watching. It's always appreciated, and please let me know in the comments if you guys like videos like this, and I'll see you guys next video. Peace. Hey, pop out, hey, pop out.